Let me show you a couple of ways to save the project. And you can go to File and click on Save, and that's what you need to do. I already did that, so it already has a name, so I'll select File, Save As, and that should, and you should see something like this menu where it's prompting you where you want to save it. And I created a folder called Ansys Files, and I'll give it an appropriate name, so I'll say 2D underscore conduction. I was drag kicking and screaming from Linux to Windows, so I tend to put in underscores because you couldn't use spaces for file names in Linux. Okay, when I do that, and now if I go to that folder, okay, I see there is this WBPJ file, and then there is this folder. Underscore files, and this is a folder. And if you go in, you see it has a bunch of other folders and so on. And then this backup will go away when you ex save and exit the project. And you need to save both the WBPJ file and the this folder. I've seen students tripping up because they have saved only the WBPJ file, and that way you cannot retrieve the project. And no amount of cursing and screaming at the software will solve the issue. Now there's another way you can save it, and that is you can say File, Archive, and then this saves it in the WBPZ format. So I'll say Save, and it says, "Do you want to save results?" I don't have results. The only reason you would deselect that is if you had a big model and you didn't want to save, the nodal temperatures in the big model. So you'll get a compact. If you deselect this, you will get a compact file that you can email to a co someone in your cohort or your colleague and so on. In this case, we can leave that on. And if you have imported files, it's also a good thing to select that unless you want to save on space to share it with somebody else. Now, if you don't save the result, what happens is, when you retrieve the project, it'll say, "Hey, you have to regenerate the results." And you can do that just by right-clicking on solution in the solution in the finite element interface, the Ansys mechanical. So don't worry about that now. So I'll select both of those and I'll say archive. And then if I go back to my folder, I see that I should have a single file. So it zips it all, and then I just need this one file, and in this case it's 50 kilobytes, and I can just email that one file, for instance. And to bring that project back up, you can just double click on it. Or within this interface, you'll have to say File, Restore Archive, and then you see you can read in WBPZ. And when you do that, it'll ask you to save it in the conventional format. And so that's a couple of ways in which you can save the project, and you have to be a little bit careful. I've seen students, saving things to a flash drive and then running Ansys from a flash drive or a USB drive. And that tends to be very slow. So what I would recommend is that you save, you move things to a local drive, say the desktop, you run things from the desktop, and then once you are done, exit Ansys, and then you can drag things onto and save things onto your USB drive.